Welcome to Christmas on the Mount. We're so glad that you've come to experience the music of Christmas with us here this afternoon. We hope that our presentation will turn all of our hearts toward the real meaning of Christmas, the gift of God's Son, Jesus. God's Christmas gift has three unique qualities. First, it's the most expensive gift you will ever receive. Jesus paid the price for this gift with his life. Second, it's the only gift that you will ever receive that will never, ever wear out. It will last forever. And thirdly, it's a very practical gift, one that you will use every day for the rest of your life. Wrapped up in this gift of Jesus are all the benefits and all the blessings that you could ever need or want in your time here on earth. In Jesus, our past is forgiven. You are showered with passionate love, and you get to look forward to a home in heaven. Why celebrate Christmas if you're not going to open the best gift of all? Just think, not only can you and I open his marvelous gift, we can give it away freely to everyone we know. It is truly the most wonderful time of year to celebrate God's gift sent to us on that holy night. We celebrate the joyous birth of Jesus.
See you. Hello, everybody. Thank you so much for coming. Would you do me a favor and stand up, greet your neighbor, pass God's peace, and remain standing and worship with us.
To men. to mend. Then peal the bells more loud and deep. No, God's not dead and not asleep. The wrong shall fail, the right prevail. With peace on
Mary, not at power. our tradition here to read this story before the bells are rung. It's Pedro's story of the Christmas bells by Lloyd Newell. Few sounds glad in the heart like church bells ringing. In days gone by, villages full of people gathered to the sound of bells. On Christmas Day, church bells rang far and wide, resonating with hope and goodwill. The story is told of a village where the church bells stopped ringing for many years. No one really knew why, but Christmases had come and gone without bells echoing against the mountainside. The townspeople were concerned. They began to think it had something to do with their offerings. So they put more jewels, more treasures, more of everything on the altar, but the bells remained silent. Then one year, a boy named Pedro and his younger brother set out from their humble home miles from the church to attend the wonderful Christmas Eve service they'd heard so much about. The boys walked through the wind and chill more than half the day and into the night so they could join in the festivities. But just as they entered the city, they saw an old woman lying in a bed of snow. She was cold and weak and barely breathing. Pedro could not pass by without helping her. He looked into the distance and knew that he would miss the service. But he asked his little brother to go ahead and take his only silver coin, still warm in his pocket, and place it on the altar. Pedro stayed with the woman and helped her. He did not hear the organ play or the choir sing, but he did hear the bells ring. For the first time in many, many years, the people said that the bells started ringing when Pedro placed his little brother's silver coin onto the altar. No one in the church knew why, but Pedro did. He had given away what he wanted for himself to help someone else. This year, as we hear the Christmas bells ring, remember the wondrous gift that was given so long ago in Bethlehem. As we unselfishly give, we too will hear the bells on Christmas Day.
Thank you.
hear this reading of the Christmas story from Luke 2, chapters 1 through 15. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken in the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. So everyone went to their own town to register. Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, to the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them. There were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks by night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them. The glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be the sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them, gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about."
Thank you.
simplicity. It should be no surprise that the shepherds were chosen to hear the mystery of the ages, now revealed in a manger in Bethlehem. Hear this reading regarding the shepherds from Luke 2, 16 through 20. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in a manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had just heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. Although it wasn't an ordinary situation, it was, however, the birth of an ordinary baby. And the glory of God became the promise of hope, the assurance of peace, the dawn of redeeming grace.
Was just
singing Christmas carols with my family around my grandmother's old pump organ every Christmas Eve. I don't think there's anything quite as heartwarming as joining together and singing Christmas carols. So will you please stand with us as you're able and sing with us.
Thank you. Do you feel the world is broken?
We do.
Do you feel the shadows deepen?
We do.
But do you know that all the dark won't stop the light from getting through?
We do.
Do you wish that you could see it all made new? Is all creation groaning?
It is.
Is a new creation coming?
It is.
Is the glory of the Lord to be the light within our midst?
It is.
Is it good that we remind ourselves of this? Is anyone worthy? Is anyone whole? Is anyone able to break the seal and open the scroll? The Lion of Judah, who conquered the grave, he is David's root and the Lamb who died to ransom the slave. Is he worthy? Is he worthy of our blessing and honor and glory? Is he worthy of this?
He is.
Does the Father truly love us? Does the Spirit move among us?
He does.
And does Jesus our Messiah hold forever those he loves?
He does.
Does our God intend to dwell again with us?
Now hear these words from Isaiah 9, verses 6 and 7. For unto us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. At Christmas time, we celebrate that Jesus was born in Bethlehem. But Jesus is more than just a baby in a manger. His spirit can be born in you tonight. Jesus can transform your life. He is just waiting for you to accept him. Jesus offers to all of us the blessings of Christmas, which are hope, peace, joy, and love. All we have to do is accept his blessings. We've gathered here at Rocky Mount once again to celebrate Christmas, to tell a very familiar and very beautiful story. And just like the angels and the shepherds, because of God's transforming love, we have a reason to rejoice and worship our King. Let us raise our eyes toward heaven and praise the Most High. We honor and glorify him who lives forever. His kingdom is eternal and endures from generation to generation. Hallelujah. Amen and amen. Ladies and gentlemen, again, thank you to our community Christmas choir. Thank you also to our handbell ringers. Thank you to our worship band, to our trumpeter, for bringing us the music of Christmas. Also, for those that you do not see, our audiovisual techs in the back who took care of everything tonight, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen back there. It's at this point where I'm supposed to say thanks to all of you, but before I do that, thank you very much, and on behalf of the choir and all of our performers tonight, thank you, Mr. Gary Miller, for your years of service. And as we all know, behind every Gary Miller, there is a Mrs. Miller. Kim. Thank you all so much for being part of our Christmas on the Mount celebration. Please drive home safely, and Merry Christmas.